All right, so we're giving this a test, see how this is going to work, and forgive us for the audio, so we'll work that out here in the future. But I think the hope for today was just to have a roundtable discussion to talk about the big picture of faith versus fear and how we see that playing out in the midst of everything going on. And so with that, I invited anyone who wanted to be a part of the conversation, just to talk from their perspective, from the Bible, from what they're observing, what they're seeing on TV, on social media, on all these different types of outlets that we are receiving information, and then just talk about it. And the hope, though, that is that we are able to, in a weird way, create a virtual community so that we can stay connected and be able to interact with you guys. And at another point too, maybe have you guys interact with us. So with that being said, tell me your thoughts, guys, in the sense of here we are, a couple weeks in, and what have you observed, seen, felt, watched? I mean, just let's just talk about what that looks like.
Well, I was having some prayer time with Meg this morning, and one of the things that came up was to look at the good that's coming of this, and some things that came to mind was that families are in a situation where they're drawn together, or in this day and age, we usually see families, especially when there's teens and different ages like that, they're scattered a lot, so they're brought together, spend time to families need to get to know one another again. And this is a good opportunity for that. It's not a good situation, but the Lord ensures that there's good in everything. You know, they'll take any evil thing and make sure that it's meant for good. But there were some other things, too, that came up. Just giving people a chance to reflect, giving people a chance to spend more time in the Word, praying, and those people who don't know the Lord yet, they're seeking. They're going to be looking for answers that are beyond what they previously found because everything's so fast-paced. Well, it's slowed down now. So people have a lot of time in their thoughts, and they're looking for peace. And we know this is the only place to find it. So that's been my recent take on it.
A lot of times, tragedy hits, and people ask why. You know, they wonder why God would allow such a thing, or did he forget people? And the facts are, things will be happening. We live in a world that has, it's a fallen world. We have a Savior who's come to redeem the world and redeem his children. And we know confidently that God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and love and a sound mind. So that's, I think, what we're trying to balance here for our church community and others. How do we hold a sound mind when we know, as we've talked about, you know, God is for us, who could be against us? And at the same token, we have authorities in government that issue various mandates. And so where do we draw that line, and how do we draw a balance between faith and government and faith and fear? So I think if we keep a good foundation, knowing God has not forgotten us, he's always going to be there. As Tom said, good things come out of difficult circumstance, and he has equipped us already with love and power and a sound mind. We have to exercise that. Yeah.
I think real-time talk in the Horner House would be that life looks very differently right now. Suddenly I'm homeschooling, but still working remotely, still fielding clients, counseling in crisis and different things. And for me, laying awake at night, in true vulnerability, if I have a sore throat or the sniffles, do I have COVID-19? And then trying to remember, Lord, wait a second, what does your word say? You have given us a spirit of fear, but fear is very real. And it's all around us. And from a counseling perspective, it's okay to acknowledge those feelings and process through them. But what keeps coming to mind for me in the late nights of wrestling through everything that's happening around me is what I reference often in my life testimony. His promises are faithful yesterday, today, forever. Isaiah 43, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. When you cross through the waters, you will not drown. So we are going to face, whether it's COVID-19 or economy crashing, in this world we have trials. We're
right.
going to experience it, but he has called us by name. We are his. But we also don't have to pretend like we don't worry and we're not anxious. I have a college student down south wondering, is she safe? Is everything going to be okay? God knows we're broken people, and it's okay to be broken in his presence because he knows our name.
Yeah,
it's
very good.
It's interesting you brought up homeschooling because I see a lot of that on social media. People are not, this is new for them, navigating homeschooling, but for Lynn and I, we've homeschooled Elijah for the majority of his education. He's eighth grade now, and I took over as the full-time parent when he was in second grade, and it was challenging. Because we have all these expectations of what that's going to look like. We have expectations of what kind of grades we want our kids to get. And there was many days where there was a lot of frustration, there was a lot of anxiety. But I came to a place of realizing that a lot of that was from me projecting onto my child what I wanted him to accomplish out of his education.
Right.
Instead of praying and saying, okay, God, who have you made him to be? And how do I shepherd that? How do I point him in the direction that you want him to go, to who you want him to become? And so it's a lot of just letting go of myself and trusting in God that God has a plan for his life and he's on a path. And, you know, obviously homeschooling, especially with nowadays, we all know that education is not the same way it was when we were in school.
Right.
And so sometimes there's math problems where I have to go to Google in order to get help. And I'm like,
or Alexa could figure it
out. Yeah, ask Alexa, hey Alexa. And that's okay with not knowing the answers.
Yeah.
And just being, hey, I don't know, let's just do our best. Let's try our best in this situation. And be okay with not being straight A's. It's okay.
Right.
It's okay to not get 100% on every test.
Yeah,
I used to get really mad when I knew Elijah knew an answer, but yet he just got lazy and would get it wrong, and that would make me really angry. And then I just had to look. He has to want that for himself.
Mm-hmm.
I can't want it more than him. That only causes anxiety on my part. So for the homeschooling aspect of it, enjoy it. You know, enjoy it. Make it an enjoyable experience. You know, eat breakfast together in the morning. Watch a TV show before you start school. Whatever it takes to create that, make your home a pleasant and enjoyable atmosphere.
Mm-hmm. Right, as you said.
So let me toss out another question. So how would somebody be able to determine if they're living in faith or in fear? How would someone determine if their default reaction, all of a sudden they're faced with whatever the, right now obviously we've got, you know, COVID-19 right in our face. How would somebody then be able to just run a diagnostic check internally, spiritually, and say, my default reaction is faith. Wonder why. Or my default reaction to this right now is panic and fear. I wonder why.
I think for me, it would be the self-evaluation question of my action choices that I'm making. Running out to get supplies at the grocery store. Am I doing that because I'm choosing to be a good steward and provide for my family, or is it the panic of, you know, this disease is going to spread, we're all going to be in isolation, and I have to react? Am I reacting out of emotion, or am I choosing a response based on providing for my family? Which, in essence, the choice is faith. fear is a feeling, which we're going to operate out of at times as human beings. But in that moment, recognizing, wait a second, I'm operating in fear, I can make the choice of faith. To me, faith isn't a feeling, but my reaction to what's around me, take that moment to self-check, why am I prepping? Why am I doing A, B, and C? Is it because this is what the Lord says to do in certain situations and I'm going to respond that way? Or am I just going with the flow because everyone around me is panicking? So.
Yeah, I would add to that that when people, as far as knowing where are you, am I in fear or am I in faith, people tend to become afraid when they can't control a situation. So it's really a self-evaluation aspect that I'm agitated, I'm afraid, I'm reacting because I can't control the situation. Well, in our walk with the Lord, it's about Him controlling a situation. So if all of a sudden I say, it would be better if I could just do this, or if it would be better if I'm just obviously admitting I have to be in control to feel peace. Well, that's a fear mode for me, as opposed to a faith mode where, Lord, I'm going to rest, and I trust you will give some direction here, and do what you would have us do.
So I was reading this morning, and I think I obviously tossed that out to you guys for the first time, you know. But as I was thinking about it this morning, about 3 a.m., Romans 15.
That's the proper way to cough.
Right. Verse 13. Says, I pray that God, the source of hope, will fill you completely with joy and peace because you trust in Him. Then you will overflow with confident hope through the power of the Holy Spirit. And I think that struck me, obviously, as a warming verse, right? It's one that you can put in your little box and pull out and say, all right, trust, hope. But the word that stood out to me is source, a source of hope. And, you know, in a time where stock market is, you know, crazier than Great America roller coaster, and when finances or health or all these things that you think you have control over, we are quickly reminded that if our sources of hope is in those things, how quickly they come. Or rise and fall.
Right.
And then we're able to take a temperature, so to speak, to see a spiritual temperature, to see, okay, I think my source of hope is in this. If I find my immediate reaction going back to, how will I make it? Or how will I, health-wise, am I going to get this? Or my finances, everything I've invested now is gone. And while those aren't bad things in themselves, if it's our only source of hope, right, then we're going to be left feeling empty and in some probably serious fear and panic, right? It says if He is your source, then you will overflow with confident hope through the power of the Holy Spirit. And I think people, obviously within our own family and in our church community, in our neighborhoods, are in search of that source,
right?
It'll overflow with confident hope. No, I don't think I know. And to know something, you know, is it just changes the game completely, especially what the devil is all about, creating chaos, panic, and fear. I mean, he's doing exactly what he is allowed to do, and he does it well.
Yeah. I'd like to add to that in a bigger picture, we have believers around this globe who experience famine, who experience persecution, the persecuted church, I mean, lots of disease, etc., in third world countries. And You know, so we're experiencing a new normal where many of our brothers and sisters been there and back. But I believe that their hope is a similar hope that Paul talks about in Romans chapter 9. He says there in verse 37 beginning, "But in all these things we overwhelmingly conquer through him who loved us, for I am convinced that neither death nor life nor angels nor principalities nor things present nor things to come nor powers nor height nor depth nor any other created thing will be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord." Mm-hmm. And this is a thing. And the bottom line, our foundation always has to be knowing God loves us, we are loved, and we're here for him, even though we try and be good stewards of our lives, our families, our church, and everything. But when it comes down to it, we need to remember we are so loved by God, and nothing can separate us from that love. Mm-hmm.